So I'm busy just like doing a nail tutorial, and I hear Brady like playing with his toys and playing with stuff in the background, but I'm not really paying attention. I look down and look at this. Did you eat your bed? And guess who has to pick that up? Not you. Mama does. Yeah, Mama has to pick up the mess that you just chewed up. Yay! Welcome to LA. I am going downstairs to. Why is there a sticker over that? I'm going downstairs to eat. I'm so tired. It's like 10 o'clock. Good morning. So last night I just crashed out after dinner. I'm in Santa Monica right now. And I am going to be speaking at this event, at this one panel that is about like beauty tech businesses. I'm not really sure what gives me the credentials to speak at that, but I don't know. I'm like thinking, I don't really know what I'm going to say. But it's going to be like a panel that I'm going to speak on, so there'll be other people. My producer from Beauty TV will be there as well with me, so that will be cool. So anyway, just heading out. I don't know what all I can film, but I'll try and film as much as I can. So this is it. This is where we're going to sit. And I'm with Ava. Hi.
Hey
What are you
guys.
drinking?
I'm drinking a refreshed tea from Starbucks, which
Yum.
I normally don't get, but they recommended it to me, and it tastes like literally like mint and leaves just like blooming in your mouth. So
I'm gonna have to try that.
it's good. Yeah.
So we're heading into Ipsy right now. So today's been a busy day. I changed my dress and I brushed my teeth and I got toothpaste on my dress. And then, I forget what, I lost my train of thought. Some people drove by and I'm like, get all shy. So we're coming to Rite Aid. This is where I'm gonna have my meetup tomorrow. So I'm gonna check things out. Oh, this looks so great.
This is Stephanie.
Hi, Stephanie. How are you? And we're here with Leslie from Workplay Polish. Can I see your nails? I like that.
Using the Cruise collection.
Oh, using my stuff. I love it. Cool. So we're like checking out the nail polish here and we're straightening it up because some of them are out of place. So this is Leslie's first time in LA. So we're taking a super fancy LA tour. So Jesse's taking us to Rodeo Drive, and then we're gonna go, since we both love The Housewives of Beverly Hills, we're gonna go drive in front of Villa Blanca. I'm actually really excited about that because I've never been there. Are you excited about
Yeah,
that?
I hope to see Jakey.
I know,
First of all.
like just in the front.
Yeah.
So we're here on Rodeo Drive now. Leslie, what do you think?
It's pretty awesome.
There's Villa Blanca. Cool. Oh, it's so pretty. Go, Lisa
Oh,
Vanderpump.
they're looking
Arrived at Villa Blanca.
Villa Blanca. So I decided to come out to the pool and have a Midori sour. Julie G,
713, you're here too. I just came outside to have a drink.
And you found me?
And I found you.
Yeah, I did Pilates, and apparently it was way too advanced for me. So now I'm just walking like an old lady. Watch. That sucks, right?
She's like, Julie, look at how I walk.
I might have pulled something. I'm good, no. But it's always such a good time with Julie. Julie's so much
You
fun.
too. You always make me laugh.
And Julie is so much better in person. She's kind of a little bit of a saint on these vlogs here. Nasty.
Cut. Good morning. Today's the day of the meetup. I always get a little bit anxious the day of the meetup because I'm always like thinking, what if nobody shows up and I'm sitting there like by myself with my party hat on and nobody comes to my birthday party?
Marissa's in the shower right now. We're going to film a get ready with me video.
So we're going to film it, but we don't have a tripod, so we're trying to just stack things. So what do we have? We have an ice bucket, and then the room and dining menu, and then her iPad, and some toilet paper.
That's right. We're doing old school video.
That's old so school old school.
YouTube.
Taking it back. Look how pretty Marissa looks. I told her she looks like a little whimsical fairy princess. Like you should be talking to animals in the forest.
I'm going to.
So we're getting ready to head out now. I don't know if I told you guys about this dress, but I got this from H&M yesterday. I was in the promenade in Santa Monica, and I was like, ooh, I like that. So I got this. Marissa's getting her stuff ready. We're about to leave. And then, with room service, we got these flowers, so I'm going to bring this to our meetup.
I'm kind of nervous about this meetup.
Don't be.
If nobody shows up, at least I still have you and my flowers.
If no one shows up, at least there's Thrifty's ice cream.
Oh, I've never had this ice cream.
Oh,
apparently
it's
a good ice cream.
In Vegas, well, we don't really have a Rite Aid. We have one Rite Aid in Vegas, but there's no ice cream there. But California Rite Aids have Thrifty's ice cream still.
Okay, well, we'll have to try that then.
Yeah.
What's your favorite flavor?
I'm going to say 300 North Cannon.
300?
Yes, 300 North Cannon.
I like cookies and cream and mint and chip.
Mm, that's a good one.
Mm, their pistachio is really good.
I love pistachio.
Even their vanilla, just plain vanilla, it's really good.
So this is Jane from Kentucky.
Hi.
And I did her nails.
Mermaid's tail.
Do you like it? It's like super,
oh,
like glittery, shimmery amazingness.
So pretty. You can see it shining.
Yeah.
Shining.
Yeah, we're talking about the Kentucky accent.
Oh, no.
It's super cute. Yeah. So what are you doing?
I'm handing out goodie bags.
She's giving goodie bags.
Oh,
what'd
you guys get?
This is
like a scarf.
Great
nail file.
Yeah.
Lotion.
Right. Oh, you guys got a good app. The little one fits in your purse.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a lipstick in there too?
I put it with that.
Nice.
Wow.
Oh.
You got good stuff.
Oh my god. So I just painted Anna's nails with cherry on top. And this is her first time wearing red nail polish. Yeah. Do you love it?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yes.
So cool. Thank you.
Also, Leslie is doing a really cool design here. That's awesome.
Very edgy.
It is very edgy, and it goes with your black and white outfit. Super cute.
Super easy, too.
Okay.
Know about a Cinderella hand. They know.
Oh my god, let me see these. Julie G. That is so awesome. Thank you.
She's using your product.
Oh really?
Yeah, it's Cabana Boy underneath confetti.
I love it. Thank you so much. That's gorgeous. So we just did Canary Islands.
Yeah.
And someone got ice cream.
That's why I'm here. For the ice cream.
Is that the only reason you came?
Mm-hmm.
What did you get?
Mint and chip.
Mmm. So we just finished painting nails. Leslie, you did like a ton of nails today.
It was fun.
So we started at like 10 o'clock and then we just now finished. It's around 4 o'clock. So I've been doing nails all day. It was fun. So now we're gonna go eat, I think. So we're about to go into Villa Blanca.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So this is us inside of Villa Blanca. It is so beautiful in here.
Right over our head. Like.
I'm just vlogging my food. So I'm having the paella with a whole bunch of different seafood in it and some rosé. Good morning. So I'm wearing a lifeguard sweater, even though I don't know how to swim. I would not be able to save you. So Marissa and I are at the beach. Look how nice this is. Oh my god. And so we have our coffee and we're just hanging out.
Hanging out, showing Julie the ropes.
You can see that baby literally crawling in the water. Oh, he's not doing it anymore because I stood him up, but it's so cute.
Headed back home. We're at LAX now.
Thank you so much for everything, Riss Rose.
You're so welcome. Anytime, Julie.
Thank you.
So I'm at the airport. I'm going to have something to eat, but I'm watching the World Cup, and I never realized how hot these soccer players are, so I'm officially a fan. Pretty hot guys.
Good morning. So I am in, let's see, what's this? Hershey. I'm in Hershey, Pennsylvania right now. And I flew from LA to Chicago, and my flight got in late to Chicago. And so like right when my plane was getting into or was on the runway, not even getting up to my gate, my flight here to Harrisburg airport was already like taking off. So I was like, man, I missed my flight. No. It turns out my flight to Pennsylvania was running an hour late as well. So I completely lucked out because it was so late at night that I don't even think they would have had any other flights going out. So I lucked out that, you know, my flight came in or left late. But the downside is that I didn't get here to Pennsylvania until what time? I think my flight came in around midnight, maybe 12:30 midnight. And then I had to take the hotel shuttle, which took a long time. And then I didn't get to my room till like 1:30 maybe. So I was exhausted and I was delirious and I was carrying my heavy bag and I got lost trying to find my room. And like the sweet man, oh my gosh, this sweet man helped me find my room. He works here. I think he was like with like maintenance or something. And I was like, can you help me? I was like almost on the verge of tears because I was so sleep deprived and I was like so like, I was just deliriously tired. And he's like, where's your room? And I'm like, he's like, I'll take you there. So luckily he helped me. Otherwise I don't even know what I would have done. I would have like just slept in the hallways or something. But anyway, let me unplug my phone since it's charging. This is the room. I'm at the Hershey Lodge, and this is what it looks like. So everything's like Hershey. Oh, they gave me this amazing little treat while checking in, if I could find it. Oh yeah. So I'm just here for the day, pretty much. I leave tonight around 6 p.m. So, I'm here for like a blogger event. I'm not really sure what to expect of it, but Rite Aid wanted me to come out for it. And I don't know what to expect. I know I'm going to be part of a speaking panel in like an hour or something. I'm going to go have breakfast and then I'm going to speak at some kind of event that I don't really know much about. So I mean, I'm not trying to be like secretive or anything. I honestly don't really know what I'm doing. I'm like, I don't know what I'm doing here. So anyway, I'm going to go eat breakfast. I'm going to have some coffee and then get my life together. So this is what the hallways look like. And I had no idea I was staying at the Hershey Lodge. So I thought that was kind of cool. They have like a theme park down the road, which is crazy. So look at my room key. It even has my name on it. How fancy pants is that? The sweetest place on earth. Oh man, I need a cup of coffee. So this is where we're gonna do our little panel. What are they going to have up there?
The universe. You know?
The universe.
That's what they're trying to work on right now.
Oh, I see.
So I'm now getting a lovely hand massage. Oh, it's so nice. This one dries, I think it dries in like 5 minutes.
So it takes a little bit longer.
Look what happened to one of my Sigma brushes. I was just using it and it like snapped in two. I think the glue just came loose or something. So I'm just gonna have to throw this away. There's like no way I could put this back on. It just falls off. No!
So we're having lunch right now. And this is butter, but it's chocolate butter. Check this out. How awesome is that? Wanna get a little bit of that?
Bread here. Mm. Oh, it happens. It's really pretty here. Everything's so bright green and beautiful. Yes.
So where's home for you?
It's New Mexico.
Oh,
everything's brown and dead. Not like it is here.
We're very fortunate, believe it or not.
So I'm here at the airport. This is like the tiniest, cutest little airport. I've been sitting here at baggage claim for about an hour because I couldn't check into my flight because I got here really early. And there's been like literally two flights that came in. So I love this airport because it's tiny and cute and not chaotic and crazy. So I think it's about time that I need to go check into my flight now. I still have my luggage here with me. I was just like talking to my mom on the phone, chatting with her for a bit. So gotta check in now. Oh my God. So my flight to Albuquerque got canceled. So I stood in line for like 2 hours so they could fix it. And the guy was so nice to me. I was like, I don't know what to do. So he booked a hotel for me, and I don't have access to my luggage until tomorrow when I arrive in Albuquerque, because they're going to put it on the plane tonight for my plane tomorrow, if that makes sense. So I can't get my luggage, so I bought some deodorant and toothpaste and a toothbrush, all for $16. I'm like, freaking price gougers. But anyway, I'm stuck here in Chicago for tonight, and I thought that was kind of cool. Like, I mean, I've never been to Chicago, so this is my first time visiting Chicago. And then they also gave me a dinner voucher, so I'm here just having dinner at the airport, and then I'm going to head out to catch the hotel shuttle. I'm exhausted. I'm running on, like, 3 hours of sleep, but it's okay.
I'm on my...
This is nuts. So, okay, so I finally got on the shuttle, and I'm talking to this girl. She's from Albuquerque as well, and I'm like, yeah, I'm like so tired trying to get to the hotel. I don't know what I'm gonna do about my makeup. And she's like, oh, I have some makeup wipes here. And I'm like, oh, thank you so much. So, like, she let me use her makeup wipes to take off my makeup. And then our driver is like insane. He's like fighting with his girlfriend on the phone, and we're just looking at each other like, oh my God. And he's like cussing at her, and he's just like, I guess he fell asleep on the phone or whatever with her, and she got all mad. He's like yelling at her, and we're just like, what is going on here? But this chick is so cool. She just like let me use her makeup wipes. So I gave her some Julie G nail polish.
So this is the hotel. Oh my God. What a day. My driver was insane. Oh my God. I could tell I didn't even like take off all my makeup, man. That girl was a lifesaver. I was just like, that was like my biggest concern. I was just thinking, well, I could probably use the shampoo and conditioner from the hotel. Oh shoot. I don't think they have any. Oh man. Oh wait, yes, I do. Right there. Okay. Score. Okay. But I was like, okay, I could use the shampoo and conditioner from the hotel, the soap, but I just don't know how to take off my makeup. So I was like telling her about that, and she's like, oh, here's a makeup wipe. So that girl was like a total lifesaver. She was, flying in from Dublin too. So she was exhausted. All right, let's check out the room. Cool. All right. It is 10:30. I need to get to bed. My flight leaves tomorrow at like 10 o'clock. So my crazy driver is going to pick me up at 9. Good night. Good night. Before I let you go, I just want to show you the world's most expensive toothbrush. Check this out. $3.19 for a toothbrush. My toothpaste $5.49, and my deodorant, $6. Price gougers. How dare you, Airports? That's insane. But I was like, I don't have my stuff. I don't have access to my bag, so kind of have to do it. Oh, well. Anyway, I'm going to take a shower. See you guys tomorrow.
Good morning. The insane driver is back. There he is. You can see him. He's talking about his girlfriend again. He's insane.
My flight got messed up again. Like, I went, you know, they were boarding the flight, and I went and I gave the lady my ticket, and she's like, nope, I can't board you on this flight. So I don't know what's going on. She's working on my ticket now.
Okay, so I have a flight out at 2:30, which is about 4 hours from now. So I'll make the best of it, I guess. I'm really tired. I'm glad that I got to like spend the night at a hotel. But I'm really tired. I'm going to go back home. This is great.
Upright position. Also, secure your personal items in
I'm home. Yay. Oh my god. What an ordeal. I'm so happy to see you.
Oh, I'm happy to see you.
I'm happy to be back in the hot New Mexican air. It's so hot. I feel like LA was really cold and Chicago was really cold, like, compared to here. It's so hot here and I love it. I'm so happy. I saw a little white dog in the airport. It reminded me of Brady, so I miss Brady. I want to get back home to him. Oh my gosh! Hi! Hi! Oh god!
I'll put the phone out of my
hand. I'm here at a graduation party for one of my little cousins who's graduating high school. And I'm here bored with my brother. So we're creating haikus over here? Because we're waiting for the food to come out. I'm starving.
Get your lunch.
He told us to get our lunch, even though it's like 7 lunch. O'clock. He called it lunch. I want him to say it again. Oh, he's not. It's like 7 o'clock at night and he said to get our lunch. I don't care, I'm hungry. I'll eat lunch twice. Let's go get our lunch. Food.
The wind's blowing the thing.
We are here as family and friends to share in their joy, to surround them with our prayers, to seek God's power today.
Wow.
So today's been a crazy day. I went to my cousin's graduation. I'm with Mystery Man right now. So I went to my cousin's graduation party and I ate way too much. And then my uncle was like, hey, what are you doing after this? And I'm like, well, I'm going to another graduation party with my parents and Mystery Man. And he's like, do you want to go to a wedding with me? So I'm like, okay. It was a lesbian wedding. That was a first for me. Was that the first for you?
It was.
Yeah, yes. It was really interesting. It was really cute though. So now we're going to go to another graduation who I don't even know who the guy is. He's my dad's friend's son. So they're having an air guitar contest with my parents. Left, and I'm here with Mystery Man all by myself. My uncle actually came, but we don't know anybody here. So I'm in Santa Fe today with my uncle Modi, and my mom.
And so we just had lunch, and my Uncle Moody's going to take us to some touristy places. Where are you taking us?
The Governor's Mansion.
The Governor's,
no, the Governor's Mansion.
To the Roundhouse.
The Roundhouse.
So pretty here.
So what is this building that we're walking into?
This is the state capitol.
Oh, cool.
So what do they do here?
They enact state laws, they pass them, none of the laws, state laws, highway, health, all kinds of stuff like that.
Cool.
Speed limits.
I feel so important right now. So my mom thinks that this is Carl from The Walking Dead.
Ronnie, this is your mother. This is Carl.
This is YouTube, actually.
Oh. So we're headed to the governor's office. So official. I actually met that's the lieutenant governor, LT governor. I actually met the governor before. I was doing makeup for the debates, and this is before she was actually governor. And so I was backstage doing makeup for her opponent, and then she was like, "Hi, I'm Susana Martinez," and I'm like, "Hi, I'm Pete Domenici's makeup artist." So. That was my claim to fame, meeting the governor.
We made it. Official.
She's like that to everyone. I've known her since I was like 8 years old. And
really?
She's been the exact same.
Maybe like 9 now?
Yes.
You're 9 now.
So this is Canyon Road, and it's a bunch of art galleries.
It's very long.
Uh-huh.
We're going to go all the way to the end.
Cool.
And then we're going to go across the river. There's an old man who just ate a Dunkin' Donut. I can tell by the size of his stomach.
Oh, look at those sculptures. The bears. That's neat.
Look at this sculpture. That's cool.
Can you imagine that in your front yard?
Brady, guess what? Guess what? Okay, so today might be an exciting day because Brady's friend Zoe is coming to spend the night tonight with us. Yeah! You guys know Zoe. She's a little Pomeranian poodle who Brady plays with every now and then. She's about 7 months now. And anyway, my friend Tatiana, who is Zoe's mom, she realized that her son is allergic to Zoe. I too have a dog allergy, so I have to be very careful. Some dogs more than others. So I'm not allergic to him because he's hypoallergenic. So Pomeranians are not hypoallergenic. Poodles are, let me start over. Poodles, So poodles are hypoallergenic, but Pomeranians are not. So her son, unfortunately, is allergic to Zoe. So I told Tatiana, well, have her come spend the night with us. We'll see how it goes. We'll see how Brady likes her being around. They play a lot. They play really well together. But just to see how, you know, she does in our house, and also to make sure that I'm not allergic to her as well. So we're going to do a little trial run tonight. What is going on here? What's going on here? So I am heading out to grab coffee with a photographer. She's actually the same photographer that did my cousin's wedding. And I met her on the engagement photo shoot. So we kind of like loosely worked together before. So at the wedding, I was like, we should totally work together. Let me get your information. And so now we're finally getting together. We're just going to like have a little creative conversation and see what kind of projects we can work on. So I'm excited. And then after that, I'm going to go pick up Zoe. So this is Evelani, the photographer. So we've been just kind of jamming, talking about some
major
different ideas
jamming.
And stuff. Yeah.
Serious jamming going on.
Yeah. So we have Zoe here, even though she looks like Brady, kind of. And she's in Brady's harness and his little car seat. And she did really well on the drive over here. So now I'm going to introduce her to Brady and be like, hey, guess who's spending the night? Let's see if he'll be happy about it. I'm sure they're going to play for a while, but Brady gets tired out more now that he's not, now that he's not a little puppy anymore. So I'm sure she's going to be wanting to play and play and play. So Ready to go see Brady? Oh my god.
Yay! I took him. I decided to take them outside right away. Just in case she needed to pee, and then Brady hasn't peed because I've been gone for about 2 hours. Yeah, oh, she's peeing. Good girl! Yay! Good girl! Yay! Okay, so we're just waking up. I slept in my makeup, don't judge me. But I'm looking at Brady, and his eyes are, like, swollen.
Brady, look at me. Can you see how his eyes are, like, squinted shut? It's the weirdest thing. Look at me. Oh, my God. Brady. I think he's allergic to her. Look how his eyes are. His eyes never look like that. Because I was looking at him, and it's like, his eyes are kind of like, do you see that? That is so weird. Brady. Look at me. I don't think you can even really tell on... Look at that. Ooh. I think he might be allergic to her. Look at his eyes. Oh my god, that's so scary. Brady, are you okay? Oh, I'm sorry. Oh no, I was thinking that I might be the problem this entire time, and I think he's allergic. His eyes are just like red and puffy and like squinty. Oh man. I didn't know that that was a thing, that dogs could be allergic to each other. Oh my gosh. That's so sad.
You're so sweet. She's so much sweeter than Brady. Like, Brady, I feel like, is a really sweet dog in his own way, but he's more like, admire me from afar, whereas she's like, I want to be on top of you and just love you and just cuddle you and... Oh my gosh, you're so sweet. But Brady's allergic to you. I've never heard of that before. It's crazy. I feel so bad for him. His eyes are like, he's like, my eyes are killing me. Poor Brady. Uh-oh. Don't itch your eyes. His left one is like swelling shut. Oh, that looks painful. I think Tatiana's going to come pick her up. Is your eye okay? He's looking at me like this.
So this Jack had an arm like this, but it turned out to be all raggedy because this little guy completely destroyed his arm. So I decided to cut it off because look how raggedy it got, like completely crazy. And this is his favorite toy and I didn't want to throw it away. So bam! Your one-armed duck. His friend, his auntie Tanya got it for him. So it kind of has sentimental value to it. He's like, what happened to his arm? This is what happened. Rah! I got you. Ow. Ow, ow, ow. I'm just getting home from having some drinks. The perks of living in Albuquerque is that you randomly run into Breaking Bad actors. Victor from Breaking Bad walked into the lounge or bar that we were in, and I was freaking out. I was just like, oh my God, that's him. He's actually really tall, and I was just like, oh, that's Victor. He got his neck sliced open. Ooh, that's a spoiler. Spoiler alert. Oh my God, I'm a little tipsy right now. But
I made eye contact with him, and I'm like, that guy looks so familiar. And oh my God, it was Victor from Breaking Bad. I was freaking out. He was with some girl, so I didn't want to bother him. But oh, that was so cool. I was so excited. Today's Father's Day, but I'm at my parents' house with this young lady right here, and I have to tell her about who I saw last night. So I saw an actor from Breaking Bad just walk into the rooftop bar. So I'll give you three guesses. He wasn't a main character. It was. I'll just tell you right now. It wasn't Mr. White. It wasn't Jesse.
They were all main characters as far as I'm concerned. The twins?
Twins? That's a good guess.
I forget his name. He worked with Mr. White in the...
Who?
I forget that scientist. I forget his name.
Oh, Gale? No.
Gale. That guy that used to like Lydia. What was his name?
Todd. No. Victor. He just like walked in. He's like real tall, and
was his throat okay?
His throat was okay. I didn't really check, but his throat was okay. But he was with a girl, and like they're all snuggled up on a couch, and I didn't really want to bother them, but I was freaking out.
Yeah, that's cool. I would be too.
Okay, so you guys remember last month when Tom from Albuquerque the Magazine came to my house and interviewed me because I'm going to be in the August issue. So today is a photo shoot, and I'm like running super late, but I did Albuquerque the Magazine logo. He wanted me to do some kind of logo on my nails. And just real quickly, I'm wearing lashes that are way too dramatic for a photo shoot, and my eyebrows are sticking up. And I'm wearing this dress. This is like an oldies but goodies dress. I've had this for like a million years. I think I got it at Dillard's a couple years ago. It's actually the same dress that I was wearing for my original Julie G nail polish photo shoot. And then this necklace I think I got from Forever 21. And then I curled my hair. I have cafe au lait on the lid. I really need to go in because I'm like super late. I'm running super late.
So this is Antonio. He's helping me take pictures for the magazine. Is this going to be, I was going to say, is that the cover?
But this is the cover.
Am I going to be in front of that?
I'm going to use this as a flag.
Oh.
Just a box of light, but.
Okay.
Good to see you out in the magazine.
Nice. Yeah. Cool.
Well, that was fun. The photo shoot literally lasted like 20 minutes. He was like, okay, we're done. So I'm like, okay. And I'm like getting my stuff ready. And I'm like, oh crap. Did I leave my nail polish? I think I left my nail polish because he was taking nail polish shots. But anyway, I was like getting all my stuff together, and I'm like, if you want to take more, I that's totally fine. And he's like, okay. So we took a little bit more pictures. Cause he was like, you probably have a busy schedule. And I'm like, not really. So we took more pictures, and he kind of showed me how they looked on the camera, you know? And I think they looked pretty good. So I'm going to head back home. One of my cousins is in town. She just had a baby. That was the baby shower that I went to a couple months ago. So she's in town, and so is the baby, and I want to go meet him. I'm lost. I swear, like certain parts of Albuquerque, I'm just like, I don't know how to get around. So I need to put on my maps. Yeah, I'm like that person. I can't get around my own hometown. Okay, I need to put my maps on. I just changed. I am in the parking lot of Best Buy, and I kind of parked away from other people. And then right as I'm like taking off my dress, somebody pulls up, like not like right next to me, but kind of like behind me, next to me, so you could totally tell that I'm getting undressed in here, but I tried to be a little bit discreet. Anyway, I got this new lens for my camera because I'm trying to have like better quality videos for you guys. So I got this lens that's gonna like blur out the background, and it's hopefully gonna be really, really good. It's gonna look good. Okay, so we're at Best Buy now. I'm gonna go in and I pre-ordered it or pre-bought it. Oh my god, there was a huge bee outside. Wish you guys could have seen that. That was crazy. Oh look, here's some little kids who just rolled up next to me. So my timing is really good. Okay, I gotta go get my lens. Okay, I picked up my lens. Walking in there, I could tell the car behind me like knew that I was getting dressed, so they were kind of, there was somebody in the car and I guess the other person had gone inside, but they were just kind of, I could feel them staring at me. I'm like, yes, bested me. I was changing my car, okay. It's just that the dress that I was wearing was a little bit like kind of revealing, and this is just like a long dress. So anyway, I got this Canon EF 50mm f1.8. So this is what's going to give me like that depth of field and make everything like just really blurry and like really pretty. So I'm excited. I'm going to go, actually kind of want to go home and use this. My mom hasn't called me back to set up a time to go visit my cousin. So I guess I'm going to go home, film a video, and then just wait until she calls me back. Okay, so this is Albuquerque Magazine logo, and so I tried to do my nails as close to that as possible. So that's what I came up with. See how there's like a magazine around like this part? That's like a magazine. So yeah, I think I came kind of close. So today I'm going to go see my cousin's baby. Again, this is the baby that we had the baby shower for back in March or April. So he's here in town. They live in a different state. So, yeah, I'm going to show you my dress. I haven't worn this dress in a while and I gained a little bit of weight. So I have like this newfound cleavage and I'm like, whoa. So ignore all of that. But this dress, it has ruffles that go like above my waist. So it makes my waist look like kind of thick. And it doesn't really give me much shape. So I just decided I put this denim vest over, just so I don't look like so bulky. It's so obvious that I've gained so much weight. And then I'm wearing this head, not like a headband, but I don't know what these things are called. I think they're kind of like hippie-ish. I don't know. I think they're fun. Anyway, I'm going to go pick up my parents, and then we're going to go to my cousin's mom's house and see the baby. I think he's like a month and a half old now. Ooh, little baby, so excited.
Yeah. Brady, come here. Come here. Oh, where did all your hair go? Where did all your hair go? Did Mama chop it off? Where is it?
So I couldn't really finish up his face because he kind of has hairs kind of going everywhere. And then his front legs are still bigger than his back legs. I couldn't really get to those. Yeah, but meet Mini Brady over here. That's everything that I cut free or use the shears with, or the clippers. So, yeah, he doesn't have any tangles. He had so many tangles, so I had to cut so much free, but that's the only reason why I took so much off.
I'm just watching the Kardashians and I turn around and his face is literally in the pillow. Like, I can't deal with life right now.